Hi y'all, Shane here at Lana 67, and this is a video by request, and of course no focus, never mind. So this is going to be the introductory video from a figure painting tutorial, as requested by Tactical Jack Lube. So Andy asked me would I do one, and I said I would, most certainly. Not as eccentrically of that, of course, but anyway, I'm talking shite. As all good Irishmen should. Right, so, what have we got? We have got one Fallschirmtruppen, or Fallschirmjäger, German Airborne. This is from the Swesda German Airborne set, which is based, I think, with the type of equipment they're wearing and the type of smock. That's the second pattern smock, I believe, or first pattern. That should date them around Operation Mercury, or Mercury, the invasion of Crete. In 41 or 2, I can't rightly remember, I think it's 41, but you could easily backtrack them to the operations in Holland and in Norway. But so I've done a little bit of work. I should have by right done a video with the how I prepared the model to this point, but to be honest with you, it's been done a million times before and you all know how to do it by now. So I've done some changes quickly just to run it down. The equipment is from Dragon Gen 2 sets, so MG or MP40 pouch, Fallschirmjäger gas canister, which is made out of cloth rather than steel, so they would hurt themselves on the jump, bread bag canteen, Luger holster. As in all Fallschirmjäger were all issued regardless of rank one pistol. So every Fallschirmjäger had a sidearm, and the reason for that is when they jumped from the aircraft, they jumped only armed with a sidearm. All their equipment, their personal weapons and everything else was put into a canister, was dropped. It was the first thing to be dropped, and then the stick, as in the parachutists would jump behind it. I know this is out of focus, but we're going to reset in the morning, because it's better to have natural light as well. So this is just more the introduction, so don't worry, the quality is going to be better. I've replaced the head of the resin head from Hornet. It's a bit more dramatic, and I kind of wanted a bare head so I could talk about painting faces. So this is going to be a little bit of a long tutorial. I might do it in stages, but I'm looking forward to it, and I really like Fallschirmjäger subjects, so it's going to be interesting to paint up this chap. I think he's going to be a lieutenant, a first lieutenant, so he's going to be like a first lieutenant or second lieutenant, I think. Sorry, the lowest rank lieutenant can be. He also has an MP40 submachine gun. Swesda had the great idea, and actually I'm not being sarcastic, I actually think it's a great idea, of having the hands molded onto the weapon. It also gives you the option without, if you remember my review a couple of months back. So it gives a pretty natural feel. So this is all going to be painted in a mixture of airbrushing and brush painting. It's going to be based with airbrushes, and then all the layering and highlights and shading are going to be done with brush, all with Vallejo paints, unless I state otherwise. Is it going to be a step-by-step start-to-finish style build, and depending how many times I... never mind. So basically it's going to be start-to-finish, I'm going to try to include everything and explain as much as I can. Figure painting isn't as difficult as it sounds. A lot of people kind of have a preconceived notion that figures are hard to paint. I actually find figures easier than tanks. Okay, so this is going to be the first step. Next step is going to do in the morning, which is just coming on midnight here now. So Monday morning I'm going to start filming part 2. I'll have all the paints laid out, various brushes that I intend to use, airbrush, I need to switch out my needle for my 0.2 needle for detail work, and we'll take it from there. So I'll see you in the morning, lads, and let's hope this will be of use to you. Okay, see you in a bit. Hiya, welcome back. Right, it's still on the morning, but that's how I'm going to shoot the paints that we're going to be using. So first things first, I just want to first talk about the figure again for a second. So I've, after drilling out the figure's foot and insert a paper clip, a bit of super glue, hold it in place, and I hold my pin vise, and so it allows you to very easily move the figure for ease of painting, so that's that aside. So to prime the model, I always like to prime my model, my figures in black. So I'm going to be using Vallejo Surface Primer Black and apply to the airbrush. Alternatively, if you are following this and you use paintbrushes, just apply a black matte with your brush just as easily. Okay. Okay, so base colors for the uniform and trousers. So field grey for... Actually, it's been a while since I painted a Fallschirm. Yeah, okay. So field grey for his trousers and German uniform for his jump smock. I'm actually going to be using both either way, but I'm going to be intermixing just to get different tones. Again, it will become more apparent as we go through it. Any white details like the German eagle will be picked out in sky grey. I never use white. It also gives a very good kind of sewn effect, as in the white tread of the eagle. So black for his boots, and then going to highlight it with German camo black brown, make a bit more worn leather. Gunmetal and oily steel for the steel elements. German camo beige for mixing for some of the equipment, and light brown for certain elements of his equipment, like his canteen and whatnot. I'm also going to be using just add a bit of tonal difference. I love my favourite word, as we all should know by now. A Citadel colour. It's a little bit hard to find now, but whatever. I'm going to be using Meridian Blue for his bread bag and canteen. As if anyone's been on reenactor sites, the Luftwaffe actually had their bread bags dyed Luftwaffe blue, and this is it'll do for this purpose. I do have Luftwaffe uniform on the way, so if it arrives before we get to that stage, we'll use that instead. And then for washes, it's either going to be using Citadel's Agrax Earthshade, or failing that, I'll be using Shadow Brown, one or the other. This is just like an alternative for anyone, because like there's a place that sells Warhammer all over the world, and they're free to come by, and they're great washes. And then for the flesh, we'll be using a Triad, so it'll be based with dark flesh tone. Then it should be given a wash of this, which is an artist acrylic. You can also use an oil if you wish. Burnt Sienna. And then, depending, we might do our first highlight back with the base tone, and then our final highlight with Sunny Skin Tone. And we also might do a stubble on them as well. We'll cross that when we come to it. I think I might add a bed and a stubble. It should take them quite well, actually. So that's all the elements of paints we're going to be using. Brushes we'll be using will be Cotman's. Very, very good brush. I really enjoy them. So we'll be using Cotman Zeros. 000, the long one, just handy for getting into tight areas. And this airbrush is a bit knackered, but I got a few on the way. Number 4, which I use for most major blocking in work. So they're the four. These are Winsor & Newton Cotmans. These are synthetic. I like them. Some people prefer natural hair. I think it's horse hair or something they're made out of. They are just they're a superior brush to the synthetics, but they're a bit more expensive. So I just went with these, because these cost me like actually I think the prices on these, they're like 8-9 euro a pop. So these are good brushes. They're a little bit haggard out now at the moment, but I've had these since October or November. So I've got a good long use out of them, and so now they're beginning to deteriorate a little bit. So that's what we're going to be using. So I'm going to go ahead and prime this. There's no point you seeing that. I'm just going to prime it in surface primer black, and then I'll let that cure overnight, and then in the morning we'll actually get down to the actual tutorial proper. So thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning. Bye bye. Welcome back. So it is 11 o'clock Monday morning. Gosh, quite a bit of stuff done this morning, so now at the painting desk. So as you can see, you can natural light, you can see the various details. The face is pretty well done. So everything's been primed, but now I'm going to start base coating on blocking. For this one, I use my airbrush. There's two logics here. Some people like to begin with the flesh areas and work their way down, or some people prefer to work with the uniforms and work their way up. I like to kind of work uniform up, or that it doesn't matter, like, you know what I mean. So you can easily start from the head down, or from the uniform up. It's up to yourselves. There's no real issue with that. So the first thing we're gonna do is break out the airbrush. So we'll just use an airbrush as a means to block our colours. So I'm going to spray everything first in... So we're going to start with the uniform. So I'm going to spray everything first in Vallejo model colour German Field Grey. I'm going to try not to spray his face that much, but we are going to get some overspray. So. Drops. Doesn't really matter if you can alternatively have the black area showing through. I don't really care. So it doesn't really matter if you cover everything, because the wash is going to add our shade anyway. And you'll actually see why it's so handy to have this on mounts on a pin vise now in a few moments. Okay, a bit more paint. Now, alternatively, you could do this by brush. So I break my painting of a figure into a couple of stages. So the first one is priming. Priming and base coating. So I tend to prime in black, and that also acts as my undercoat. Then I do my blocking, which is what I'm going to do now, and then it's going to be highlights and detail work. So it's three stages. Now they are very broad stages, but it's just easy to follow. Okay, so we begin. So, I'm just going to start by nice light coats, keep moving the model, no build-ups. And then alternatively, if you're doing this with a brush, keep your paint nice and tinned. If it's Vallejo, you can just use water, or even what I tend to do now is that I tend to use airbrush thinner in my paint, even on brush painting. I know it's not quite what it's designed to do, but it does the same job as any other thinner, to be honest with you. So it just gives you good flow and good control of your paint. The thing about figure painting is patience is your best weapon. Take your time and enjoy yourself. Take as many breaks as you want. Your model will wait for you. I mean, don't be rushing yourself. It's not a competition. So not only do we do painting tutorials, but I also do philosophical debates apparently now. Lack of sleep deprivation for the win. Yeah, I didn't sleep that well last night, so kind of running on fumes a little bit. I'm grand though. I'm just going to start slipping slowly into madness during the course of this video. So as you can see now, model is almost base coat. It's actually a few little bits and pieces I need to being careful not to build my paint up too thick, because it's actually a very crisp model. And the beauty about using an airbrush, even if you don't have like a fancy airbrush, I'm using a Harder and Steenbeck Evolution. The advantage of using an airbrush for blocking your colours is it gives you incredibly smooth surfaces in which to work, and that is kind of what we want. So that's the basic base coat, yeah, you know what I'm trying to say. So this is our main block, and then what I'll do is I'll do a little bit of masking once this dries, the spray in his head with dark flesh. My brush control just isn't good enough yet, as in with the airbrush, to spray that in. And once that's done, we will allow things to set a little bit, and then we'll begin to layer up. So not to worry. So I'm going to just clean out my airbrush, and we'll be back in a moment. So hang tight, lads. And we're back. Alright, so I've literally just left it for about 10-15 minutes. It's sufficiently dry to continue, so quick kind of first twisty to see where we're at. Okay, so next part now is the flesh tones. If you felt the need, you could build up a few more like base layers. I'm happy with this. First things first, I'm going to add me a layer of dark flesh to my airbrush. So I'm just going to give it a good shake. I spray quite a bit of model air through the airbrush, and I've got pretty good results from it. So just takes a little bit more tinning. 60-40 tinner is what, 60% paint and 40% tinner is what I find that works pretty well actually. So I'm just backflowing my airbrush just to get some. There we go. So sorry, make sure you can actually, we're in shot. The only thing about model air is that it clogs on your needle very quickly, so you need to keep wiping. Okay, this is starting to backfire a little bit. So, it kind of spattered all over him, but fuck it.
watching American TV shows like the Big Bang Theory online. The government has given an order to several streaming websites to stop showing programs, although it hasn't explained why. Chinese TV stations already face strict regulations about broadcasting like
It's going to be mad. I ran into a bit of a snag with my airbrush, so I'm going to need to go back and sort this back. So yeah, we had a minor disaster with the airbrush. We got paint spatters feckin' everywhere. Not a big deal, but just a bit annoying. So we'll use this as an excuse. So I just have my nuzzle soaking in, you can't really see there, soaking in a bottle cap of airbrush cleaner, just to loosen up some of the paint. That's the only thing, that if you don't clean it correctly, it clogs. So I'm just going to let that soak, and we'll use this as an opportunity to show some skills with painting just with the brush. So this time I'm just going to do a drop or two of model air. I'm using a Cotman number 4 brush. This brush has seen better days, a bit knackered, but it'll do. The tin is just going to put a drop or two of ultimate thinner, or water, you know. I just find this actually kind of helps increase my flow. So this is the consistency of paint that we want, not this area here. So watch, you can see how it flows. Now do not touch your model with a load of brush like that, you will destroy it. So clean off your brush once you've mixed, and only apply a small bit. You don't need that much paint, and we begin. The thing about brush painting is really it's layered. You can't use this brush, this piece of shite. Well, it's not a bad brush, it's just that it's gone, it keeps breaking apart on me. So I'm going to switch out, apply the brush I can switch out too. Yeah, I do. Yeah, you can see. So the trick about painting a brush is keep it very, very thin and build up in successive layers. But also be aware that when you're using thin paint, it tends to pool. So a way to avoid this is not having that much on your brush. And if you do, just constantly working, so you know, if you see a pool, pull it in a direction away from that area. And just take your time. I can't stress it enough. Take your time. Just take your time. There's nothing to it. So you can kind of see the face is beginning to come to life. I'm also going to paint his hair in the base tone, because then I'm going to give him kind of a strawberry blonde proper Aryan hairdo. Also kind of helps give a youthful impression. Only one thing I found, this head is from resin head from Hornet, so I replaced the original piece, which was a bit blocky. I dremeled out the neck cavity, had to do a little bit of sculpting. Sorry about that, my memory card was full. So I had to, as I was saying, I had to do a little bit of trimming and filling just to get the fit in. His neck is slightly too long, but what can you do? keep building up your layers. The beautiful thing about Vallejo is that it sets very quickly. And it's a bit of a humid day, it's not that hot, but maybe 12-13 degrees Celsius. It's probably setting to the touch within about maybe 5 minutes, which is great, because that's why I don't like working with oils. Well, one, because oils terrify me. If you want to see oil tutorials, I believe Hanneker Bacchus, he does some good tutorials with oils. So that's what I say. I'm gonna go to the likes of Cohen C of Hanneker Bacchus or Barkus to see different ways of doing figures, different styles. You know, Hanneker's style is different to mine. Cohen's style is different again. So and you might find you might like their styles more than mine. I mean, each are right, but each have different styles and different type of finish. Sorry, no. I'm sticking there. So, now what I'm going to do is go back and repaint my jump smock. As in, I got some, you can see, kind of spattering. And things were going so well, so I'm just going to paint in his hair again, nice and light. This has to be too the first coats don't have to be that even, because you're going to build it up. The fear often is that if it's too light and it's kind of watery and I can see through it, well, your instinct is like, oh, put more paint on. Don't do this. Just allow it to dry and come back and apply under a coat and do it this way. So take your time. So there we go, face is done. So I really recommend Hornet heads. They are a bit expensive, you know, you're talking £9 or £10 a set, if not a bit more. So if you know where to go, if you've gone to the Chinese merchants, you can get these quite cheap, and that expression is amazing. The reason why I picked this expression is that it's like he's shouting to his men, kind of like, follow me, or lift and shift the machine gun. Do you know what I mean? Like he's pushing into an assault, and he's trying to rally his men, you know? And there's a sense of urgency too, and I like that. And okay, so I'm just going to let that dry, and I'm going to come back and give it a second coat. The second thing I'm going to do now is going to come back and clean up the overspray. So again, I'm going to do this with a paintbrush. I could easily gone back and sprayed it once I cleaned out my airbrush properly and cleaned out my nozzle. But I kind of want to use this as an opportunity to demonstrate how to brush paint, because I know not many modelers have airbrushes, and I didn't have one until recently either, so it's just good to show the more traditional way. So now I'm mixing, you can kind of see this is just like an old lid. I'm mixing water into this one just to show that you can use water as well as conventional thinner for Vallejo. Never have any problem with it, it works very well. So once again, you can see from mixing, my brush is loaded with paint. We don't want that, so I'm going to bring up my kitchen roll and remove the paint from the brush, and then I'm going to take a small amount of paint. I don't want that much, but you can see this brush is knackered. It's beginning to do this, but it's fine for what we need. You know what I mean? So it's a little bit thick compared to the airbrush, which what can you do, but that's just the nature of it. But this is more just clean up work. Well, it's not using this feckin' brush. But I have new brushes on the way, so they might arrive maybe by tomorrow. Or maybe later on today. They're either MIG or Vallejo number 4s. I can't remember which one. Sorry, I need to make sure you're still in shot, lads. So all I'm doing here is just cleaning up the oversprays. Now, if it hadn't spattered, I'd actually almost leave it and use it as kind of a pre-highlight before I apply the wash. But it spat and onto the model, and it's unsightly. And I'm not happy with doing a tutorial like that, so I kind of want to do my best for you guys. So what I'm going to do is, off camera, I'm going to just clean this up. It's so annoying because I don't have any other number 4 brushes, and this is bloody killing me using this. I probably might have to actually wait until them brushes arrive. I'll try clean this up off camera. I'm not going to move past this stage. I'm just going to clear away the paint bath. So I'll be back in a few minutes and we'll see what we'll do from there, okay? Catch you in a few minutes. Okay, so we're back. So what have I done? Well, I went back with my little brush and cleaned up the worst of the over spatter on both sides. Also went in and painted in his collar. So I painted in his collar and give his face a second coat of dark flesh. There we go. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause or stop this tutorial until my brushes arrive, because it's just not working and I want to do this right for you guys and for Andy. So I'm going to probably just stop until, I think, without the order I made from on that German store, it's courier based, so it should be arriving by tomorrow, and if not, I'll run into my art shop or my local hobby shop and art shop and buy some more cottons, so the one and the other. So it's just going to wait for a day or two. You won't even know the difference, so I said I'd pause until then, so I won't be moving past this stage, but which is actually suits perfectly actually. So this is like stage one. This is basing and stage one blocking. And then what we'll do is we'll move on to stage two, which is detail and adding shadows. And I'll also go into detail on how, into depth and detail on how I do faces, which is what many people find difficult and struggle at. I use a very easy way that I'm sure that I hope you'll find useful. So until then, my friends, I will sign off. I'll probably publish the first part of this video as part one of this video, and then part two, once the rest of my kit arrives, we'll continue. So it'll only be a day or two in between these videos. So thanks for watching. I do hope that you find this useful. Didn't find my babbling too distractful. So thanks for watching as always, my friends. Stay safe, enjoy the rest of your day, and happy modelling. And as always, watch out for those buses. See you now. Bye bye.